we're sitting here in the beautiful Pandan Bay in Mozambique. One of the most common species that we target when fishing in Mozambique is the king mackerel, otherwise known as the couta. In some countries like Australia, they call it the spotted mackerel or the Spanish mackerel. But what we're going to do is show you how we make different traces to target these fish. One of the most common ways of obviously for us to target is using a dead bait, whether it be a mackerel like this, okay, or even a dead or live bonita. Obviously we're going to concentrate on the dead ones first. What we'll do is we'll make up a trace with a flasher like this. We'll pin the bait, which I'll show you just now, and then we'll tow this behind the ski and obviously target the couta. So I'm just going to run through making up a trace and show you how we do it. Okay, first of all, we're going to start off with some basic ingredients, as you say. Two treble hooks, good quality treble hooks, four extra strong, or these ones in this case are six extra strong trebles, so nice and strong. A little lead hook or a single, small single hook, swivel, and then naturally our wire, and then a choice of a flasher or a duster, depending on the conditions, depending on the color of the water. And one of the most popular colors is your pink, or even your live glow. You get a good company like Gladiator Lures that makes some really good quality dusters and flashes. You know what the guys want, so it's good to check out and make sure that you buy a good quality duster, something that I won't skimp on as a decent duster. So what we're going to do here is we're going to make a nice pink duster. Pink being quite common for the very clean or the blue water. Tend to get a lot of fish on the pink duster. First piece of wire I've cut is my lead wire. This will be the wire that goes from the single hook to the treble. I'm just going to do this. Generally I'll cut this about 30 to 40 centimeters, not much longer than that. Even maybe 40 centimeters is a bit long, so between 30 and 40 centimeters is a good comfortable sort of length to use in a kayak. So I'm just going to assemble this quickly and then we'll show you what it looks like. One of the tricks that I use to get a very neat loop on the wire is just a good old-fashioned nail. What you do is you'll put the wire over the nail, pull it. That gives you a very, very neat loop. That nice neat loop obviously makes it a lot easier to twist the wire and obviously to keep it nice and neat. We've attached the wire to the swivel. What we've done is we've slipped the duster or the flasher onto the wire so that we can now attach the lead hook to the other end of the wire. Once again, I'll use a nail. Okay, there we have our swivel on the run side, with our lead hook on the other side, and our duster or flasher in between. One of the things we need to do is we need to make sure that the spacing of the two treble hooks on your trace is the right size for your bait. So if you have your bait before you make the trace, measure up, make sure that you can get the one hook right at the tail of the bait, and you get the other hook sort of in this little bit in the middle. So is we're going to measure the amount of wire we need so that our hooks are evenly spaced on the bait and that we've got a better chance of a good hookup. I'm going to cut the wire now according to the size of my bait, remembering to leave pieces along the end obviously for your twists, so don't go and cut the wire that size and then you twist and it gets shorter. You leave the wire a little bit longer like that, cut it, and obviously now we all connect it. Make sure it's the right size. Okay, what we've done is we've connected the one side of the wire to the lead hook. You're going through the eye of the hook itself. So basically, you'll have your lead wire coming off the eye and your one treble coming off the eye of the hook. The trick here is to not twist them. If you can imagine, you will be pulling your line from this angle, so you'll have your flasher or your swivel connected in the middle of the two wires. You have one on the right hand side and the other one will connect on the left hand side. What this does is allows us to pin the bait down the hooks down the side of the bait, okay, and it stops it from getting twisted in the front. If you don't twist it in the front, you've got more chance of your bait swimming straight as well. So preparation is a key. Making sure you do the little things like this correctly can make a big difference to how your bait swims. Once again, using my bait, I'll measure where I want to put the center hook. So if you can imagine, we've got the lead hook now and we've got the hook on the tail. Now what I want to do is position the hook in the center. So I'm going to cut the wire, taking into account obviously the twists, like I said. So I'm going to cut the wire there and get the center hook to sit about there. I was saying before, when connecting the wires to the lead hook, we don't want to get them all on one side or twisted. So one in the middle, one on the bottom. The next one that I'm going to connect will then be on this side, so it'll be out of the other two. So we'll thread it through there. And I'll do the twist on there and you'll have it all done. There we have our dead bait trace, which we're going to target a king mackerel or couta with.